Now we'll move on to study the field of statistics. But we're going to take an approach in this course that focuses on sampling. Probability is a branch of mathematics where if you make assumptions about how the world works, you can compute what will happen when you run an experiment. Statistics goes in the opposite direction. The field of statistics looks at the outcome of an experiment and tries to reason about what the world is like. It's a method of understanding from observation. And sampling ties the two together. When we sample, we're using the rules of probability in order to understand what might happen. And the way we'll use sampling in this course is to take the outcome of some experiment and try to reason about how it might have come out differently based on the observations that we have. That will allow us to reason about how the world works, or some fact about the population. So statistical inference in general is making conclusions based on data in random samples. And for example, we might want to use data to guess the value of some unknown number that's just a fact about the population that we sampled from, but it's a fact we don't know yet. When we make a guess about the value of an unknown number, we call this creating an estimate of this unknown quantity. The unknown number is just some particular value, but the estimate we make might depend on the random sample that we happen to get. And so if we ran a different experiment trying to figure out that same unknown number, we might get a different estimate, even using the same procedure, because we drew a different random sample. Some critical terminology when you're performing statistics is to know the difference between a parameter and a statistic. A parameter is a number associated with the population, whereas a statistic is a number calculated from a sample from that population. Usually, all we have is a sample, and we're trying to guess about what's going on in the population. So the statistic is something that we can compute directly, but it might be different had we had a different sample. The parameter is what we'd like to know, and we're using our sample in order to make an estimate of what that parameter might be. So a statistic can be used as an estimate of a parameter, and by doing so, we're performing statistical inference. Here, we created an estimate of a particular event. What's the chance of getting at least 1/6? So our population is all the different outcomes that could possibly happen when rolling 4 dice. Each possible set of 4 outcomes has some probability, and only some of them contain a 6. This number that we computed through the rules of probability is a parameter about the population of all 4 rolls of dice. This is an estimate that we computed empirically by running a simulation. But that estimate could have come out differently. I would call this successes divided by trials an estimate by simulation. And here we can choose the number of trials. So what if we make many such estimates? 1,000 times, I'm going to make a new estimate by taking my old list of estimates and appending on a new estimate by simulation using 10,000 trials. Now this computation is going to take a moment because 1,000 times we're computing 10,000 trials of rolling 4 dice. So we have to roll 40 million dice in order to finish all of these estimates. But while that's finishing, let's set ourselves up to draw a histogram of the results. First, we make a table with a column of estimates, and then we'll draw a histogram from that table with, let's say, 50 bins. And there's a histogram of the results. And these are 1,000 different estimates, binned. And you can see that all the estimates were between 0.5 and 0.54, where the parameter was 0.5177. Moreover, the estimates were clustered around the true parameter. A lot of them were really close. Some of them were pretty close, only off by 0.002. two or so, and then some of them were farther away. And so you can't always expect the estimate to be exactly the same as the parameter, or even to share the first two digits. But we see that they were all clustered around the parameter. It was more often that we got something close than we got something far away. And even the ones that were far away weren't that far away. 0.5 versus 0.517. What we just looked at is called the empirical distribution of a statistic. There's also a theoretical probability distribution of every statistic. So values of a statistic vary because random samples vary. And the sampling distribution or probability distribution of the statistic would show all possible values of the statistic and the corresponding probabilities. In general, this can be hard to calculate. So instead, what we'll look at in this course is empirical distributions of a statistic that we get just by simulating the estimation over and over again. That way we can avoid having to do a lot of math or having to generate all possible samples and calculate the statistic based on each sample. So, we've looked at an empirical distribution of a statistic. This is based on simulated values of the statistic, which we might try multiple times in order to get a sense of how much they vary. It consists of all the observed values of the statistic and the proportion of times each value appeared. According to the law of averages, we would expect that as long as we perform this simulation many times, the empirical distribution of a statistic will resemble the probability distribution of that same statistic. And that means we don't really need to compute the probability distribution, we can just perform the simulation like we did, and see that most of the values were right around the parameter. Understanding how statistics vary as you draw multiple samples is a core concept in statistics because when you learn about the world through observation, you need to understand how much you might have been deceived by the variability in the sampling procedure itself. And you need to be able to express that variability when you perform statistical inference.